Hello, everyone. I'm Xiongnu. Welcome to my Princess Loulan Storytelling Channel. This channel is all about sharing the mysteries of civilizations and historical figures from around the world, while also gaining some fascinating knowledge. Do you know the true purpose of the Egyptian pyramids? Interested in finding out if the Mayan prophecies were fulfilled? Have you ever heard of the Sumerian King List? If you are a story lover, delving into ancient civilizations, deciphering the enigmatic puzzles of lost civilizations, and unraveling ancient codes, then this channel is perfect for you. Join me to relax, enjoy my stories to explore the unsolved mysteries of lost civilizations. Additionally, we are not just telling stories, but also seeking the truth together. Your curiosity and opinions are very important to me. I hope you will like, share, and subscribing this free channel, and turn on the notification bell, this way you won't miss any exciting adventure in each episode. You can always come back and watch this channel whenever you want. I wish good health and good luck to all my friends who like, share, and subscribe this channel. Alright, are you ready? Let's set off on this journey together. Today marks the first episode of this channel, so let's start with my background story, the Loulan Kingdom. Firstly, let me briefly introduce Loulan according to Chinese history. Loulan was the name of an ancient kingdom in the western regions, located on the northwest shore of Lopna in present-day Xinjiang. During the reign of Emperor Zhao of the Western Han Dynasty, before 77 BC, Loulan referred to the kingdom itself. However, after Emperor Zhao's reign, Loulan referred to the city, also known as the ancient city of Loulan. In the 3rd century BC, Loulan was under the rule of the Yuezi. In 177-176 BC, the Xiongnu defeated the Yuezi, and Loulan came under the control of the Xiongnu. In 77 BC, the king of Loulan changed its name to Shanshan and relocated the capital to Yixuan city. They acknowledged the suzerainty of the Han dynasty, and the original capital, the ancient city of Loulan, was garrisoned by Han forces. Loulan was strategically located as it connected to Kumul, Jingjue, Jumi, and Yutian in the southwest, to Chaisha in the north, to Yinchi in the northwest, to the Bailong Mounds in the east, and to Dunhuang, serving as a key point along the Silk Road. Due to the diversion of the Peacock River, the shrinkage of the water in Lopna, and the increasingly harsh living conditions, the people of Loulan gradually abandoned the city and migrated southward during severe droughts after 422 AD. Loulan subsequently annexed states such as Ruoqiang, Xiaowan, Jingjue, and Kumul, becoming one of the seven powerful states in the western regions. In 448 AD, Shanshan was brought under the control of northern Wei and was governed under the county system. It was later conquered by the Gaoche in 492 AD. But what is mysterious is that after the 4th century AD, there were no more records of the ancient city of Loulan. It was not until the early 20th century that Swedish explorer Sven Hedin discovered the ruins of the kingdom of Loulan in Ruoqiang County, Bengal Mongolian Autonomous Prefecture, Xinjiang today, 7 kilometers south of the Peacock River on the west side of Lopna. History is filled with numerous speculations, and yet, how did Loulan truly vanish overnight? Some say Loulan's disappearance was due to climate changes, while others believe it was caused by shifting water sources. There are those who suggest that the redirection of the Silk Road played a role, and some even attribute it to the devastation of plagues and wars. So, what really happened to Loulan? As the Princess of Loulan, I witnessed the entire process of Loulan's final days. Today, in this video, I will share with you the captivating tale of what transpired in the ancient kingdom, revealing the mystery behind its sudden disappearance. Well, I was born twice. Let's begin by discussing the mysteries of my ancient kingdom, Loulan, and the reasons behind its disappearance overnight. Through the eyes of a Chinese practitioner, I remembered my past and present life and lamented Loulan's last moments. I saw yellow sand burying Loulan. The last to see Loulan disappear are only you and me. Let's step into the realm of history. As the last princess of Loulan, I will now reveal to you the past and ultimate downfall of my kingdom. In the city of Loulan in 313 AD, the architecture was exquisite, with a square city wall and square buildings with pointed tops. In the center of the city was the Xiongnu altar, which connected to the fifth layer of heaven and was dedicated to the gods of heaven. There was also a thorough earth altar that connected to the fifth layer of earth and was dedicated to the gods of earth. The water god Luobu hid in the clear water and nourished this land, making it lush with water and grass and full of life. At that time, Loulan was very prosperous. The young king fell in love with a minister's daughter and used all his wealth to hold a lavish wedding. After the wedding, the king and queen were very much in love. A few years later, the queen became pregnant and gave birth to a prince named Nating. 7 years later, the queen became pregnant again. When she was 5 months pregnant, a nursery prophecy rhyme began to spread in the city: the most beautiful princess, golden gauze, the most sober person, seize the gauze. The nursery prophecy rhyme was sung day by day. The king and queen learned about it and felt puzzled. Was it heaven's will for people to know that the queen would give birth to a princess? Was it the Silk Road that made Loulan richer? The king and queen went to see Lu Ming, a royal preceptor with magic power. Lu Ming said, "The nursery prophecy rhyme will continue to spread for 3 months. Please be diligent in worshipping Buddha for blessings for the country and do not slack off." Before the princess was born, the royal preceptor received Buddha's will while worshipping Buddha: protect the princess from bullying and be her guardian for life. When the princess was born, the queen smelled a full house of fragrance. The fragrance lasted for several days before dissipating. The queen gave her daughter a nickname, Shangkir. Shangkir grew up slowly and was very much loved by the king. She had big eyes, long eyelashes, a tall nose bridge, fair skin, beautiful appearance, smiling face, and a faint fragrance on her body. The king said that when she grew up, she would become Loulan's brightest pearl. The queen often brought Shangkir to pray at the temple. During the prayers, Shangkir's devotion impressed the royal preceptor. The preceptor said to the queen, "I see the princess offering a pure heart before the Buddha. In the princess's bright eyes, I see the radiance of heaven." At the age of 13, the princess said to her mother, "I want to become a nun and practice Buddhism." When the king heard about this, he became furious and ordered Shangkir to be placed under house arrest. He gave her 3 months to change her mind, and only if she changed her mind would he grant her freedom. The queen's pleas were in vain, as the king refused to see her. At that time, a large influx of sexual corruption from both the East and the West had already spread rapidly in Loulan, causing a rapid decline in the moral values of the people. Many innocent Loulan people also fell into depravity. The virginity of Loulan's young girls became a highly sought-after commodity, and there were no longer any pure young girls in the country. Under the instigation of a treacherous courtier named Arihu, even the king began to frequent debauched places, indulging in his own desires. The king's transformation caused great concern for the queen. According to the long-standing royal secret code, the queen, through careful study, deciphered the secret letters left behind by previous queens. These secret letters were ancient prophecies that cryptically described major events that Loulan was destined to experience. In one of the letters, it was stated, "In the end, the king of Loulan will bring about the destruction of the country due to his debauchery and his admission of impure women into the palace." The treacherous courtier, Arihu, who had been coveting the princess all along, deceived the king on one hand while planning to poison the prince on the other. As the king became more foolish, indulging in a life of debauchery, excessive drinking, and ignoring state affairs, he wanted to bring loose women into the palace under the influence of alcohol and drugs, but was stopped by the queen. The scandals surrounding the king gradually spread throughout the city of Loulan. The king had illicit relationships with the wives and daughters of his ministers, he drank and entertained with the debauched women of Loulan, and he took a male lover. The king sank into desire and lost himself in indulgence, promising the position of the queen to the loose woman. He began to disrespect gods and Buddhas, and even worshipped foreign evil spirits. His worship angered the heavens, and Loulan's calamity was imminent. In the end, the queen entrusted the princess and the prince to the royal preceptor. When the king once again brought a loose woman into the palace, the queen's attempts to stop him were in vain, and she ended her own life in front of the king. The king therefore went mad. In the vast desert sands, the ancient city of Loulan was buried. The princess, who witnessed Loulan's demise, disguised herself under the guidance of the royal preceptor and became a servant in an inn. She passed away around the age of 40. The ancient kingdom of Loulan vanished around the 4th century, approximately on 340 AD. As for the last princess of Loulan, in this current life, I was reincarnated as a practitioner of cultivation together with the royal preceptor. Hard to believe, Loulan Kingdom, in a single night, was covered by yellow sand and vanished into history, leaving only the ruins in the deserts of Xinjiang today. They alone lament the prophecy from that children's song, "The most beautiful princess, golden gauze, the most sober person, sees the gauze." The demise of Loulan is a warning to the world that when the people of Loulan indulge in luxury and lust, and disrupt the moral relationship between genders, when Loulan loses the protection of the divine, and when people repeatedly deviate from the established principles given by the divine, the catastrophic downfall of Loulan becomes inevitable. In the early 20th century, that Swedish explorer, Sven Hedin, conducted extensive excavations at the Loulan site, unearthing a vast collection of artifacts, including coins, silk fabrics, grains, pottery, 36 pieces of paper inscribed with Chinese characters, 120 bamboo slips, and several brushes. This ancient city, called the Pompeii of the Desert by Sven Hedin, astonished the entire world. Subsequently, archaeologists, geographers, and exploration teams from various countries flocked to the ancient city of Loulan and the region of Lopnur. The abundance and value of the unearthed relics in Loulan and the Lopnur area amazed the world. Among the various excavated artifacts, the hand brocade and the hand-copied strategies of the warring states from the Jin dynasty found in Loulan were especially precious. The hand brocade, dating back to approximately the 1st to 2nd century AD, was exquisitely crafted, adorned with vibrant colors, and embroidered with inscriptions like longevity and prosperity. The hand-copied paper from the Jin dynasty discovered here predates the earliest known European paper by more than 700 years. During the explorations in the early 20th century, a considerable number of Loulan artifacts were taken away by expeditions from countries other than China. The Loulan ruins are located about 350 kilometers northwest of Kuala City and 330 kilometers southwest of Ruocheong County in the northern part of Ruocheong County, Beinglin Mongol Autonomous Prefecture, Xinjiang. It is situated at the northwest corner of Lopnur, about 7 kilometers south of the Peacock River's channel, amid the Yardang landforms on the west bank of Lopnur. The site now covers an area of 120,000 square meters, nearly square-shaped, with each side measuring approximately 330 meters. The entire site is scattered within the Yardang landform group on the west bank of Lopnur. Hey, this is the legendary story about the Kingdom of Loulan. Of course, as the Princess Loulan, I'm also living in the tech age just like everyone and running a tech company. If any of you who need website design services, please feel free to email me to discuss your needs further. My email link below. Thank you. Well, this channel is all about sharing the unsolved mysteries of civilizations and historical figures from around the world. It allows you to relax and enjoy storytelling while also gaining a wealth of related knowledge. Without even leaving your home, you can expand your understanding of astronomy, geography, and unlock the unsolved mysteries of the world throughout history. Let me ask you something. Are you open-minded enough to believe in my story of Loulan's overnight disappearance? What are your thoughts on this story? Please leave a comment below to let me know. Does King Arthur really exist? What happened to the Russian Princess Anastasia? Are there still some legendary treasures in the world? Do you know which scientist can hear the sound of rainbows and see the colors of sound? Do you want to learn about more unsolved mysteries of the world and other fascinating magical stories? I want to share more stories with you, so if you have any ideas or topics you'd like to hear about, please leave a comment below, and I will create videos based on the most popular themes for everyone. Once again, thank you all for tuning into my channel. If you find this channel interesting and informative, please like, subscribe, and share it. Thank you so much. I truly love and appreciate all of you for your supports. I also wish all my friends who like and subscribe it an abundance of good luck. See you next time. Love you all and bye.